On your way up the 7,000 steps again, Clement?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the mine.
You've got that fire under control, right?
I wish I could make my deliveries more often, but the roads are getting dangerous.
Those bears are making Miss Temba so... Hello, my friend. What can I do for you on such a fine day?
I always thought it was odd that there's a layer of thick clouds covering the peak of the mountain above the monastery. Huh. Not sure what's up there, but I bet the Greybeards know. My father taught me an important lesson many years ago. He said, Gwilym, you have the whole world before you. Go out and experience it. Be whatever you want to be. So I took his advice, and here I am. This life might not look like much to you, but I'm content. And isn't that all that matters?
Have yourself a great day.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means. I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way. They're not the sort to take visitors, but I never go that high up the path anyway. Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials, but not to make conversation.
Aye.
Thank you. Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
I was just outside Iverstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Nothing like this has happened in centuries. Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind. Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems, I make this trip every few years. Until next time.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age. First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Shout at us!
Boosh!
Let us taste of your voice. Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here? We are honored to welcome a dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny. That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination. We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you. You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say. We are the Greybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice. You stand in High Hrothgar, on the slopes of Kinnarith's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice of the sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves. You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thum more sharply.
Ro!
Learning a word of power is only the first step. You must have long continued constant practice in order to use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro. Your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Well done. Again. Thank you. turn quickly. Once more. Use both words, if you can. Use both Fus and Ro. Together they will make the shout more powerful. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori. Master Bori will teach you wool, which means whirlwind.
Wind.
You must think the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb. Approach Master Bori. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori?
Vex!
Wolf!
Attack!
Now, your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Master Bori. Back. Is this your best effort? Again. Back. Boost. Try it again. Breath and focus. Quick mastery of a new thumb is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself. No, indeed not. But beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice. And soon your path will be made clear. Good. Then you will be ready for whatever lies ahead. He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, He spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition. The voice was although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship.
do that.
Any true sons and daughters of Skyrim, tell them to head to Windhelm. Ulfric Stormcloak wants to see them.
Talos guide you. At first they called us that to belittle our cause, but we gladly accept being named for Ulfric Stormcloak, the only true High King of Skyrim. We are the true sons and daughters of Skyrim, and Ulfric. He is the truest of us all. We fight to make our land great once more, to raise up strong, noble thanes, and lay low false jarls and the cowards who hide behind them.
Ain't this a surprise?
Yeah!
Ah! Looks like we lost a hero.
got a bad feeling about this. What was that?